Prince Harry has been torn apart by a Conservative Party MP who has said his brutal attacks on the royal family are desperate appeals for attention. Prince Harry and Meghan Markle officially gave up their royal family duties when they moved to the US to begin a new life with their young son Archie Harrison. But the couple have since sent numerous shockwaves throughout the world since, most notably making a number of explosive claims against the royal family during a bombshell interview with chat show host Oprah Winfrey. In April, Harry returned to the UK for the first time since moving across the Atlantic to join his family members for the funeral of his grandfather Prince Philip, who died at the age of 99. There had been optimism the prince could rebuild bridges with the likes of his older brother Prince William and father Prince Charles. But the outbursts from Harry towards the royal family have ramped up significantly since, with several more claims directed at the monarchy in a new mental health documentary series with Oprah. Andrew Rosenthal, a huge royal enthusiast and Tory MP for Romford in London, has been left furious by the actions of Harry and has launched a furious attack against the Duke. He told Express.co.uk, "The Duke of Sussex claims against the royal family have become increasingly unhinged and desperate in recent weeks. It is hardly worth dignifying each one with a response when they are clearly designed as desperate appeals for attention." Mr. Rosenthal believes it would be sad to think there is no way back for Harry following his string of bombshell claims against the royal family, and the likelihood of reconciliation is becoming more unlikely. He said, "Is there any way back for Harry? It would be difficult, given the affection the country had until very recently, to say definitively that there is no way back. It would be sad to think there is no way back." But in a new warning to Harry standing in his home country, Mr. Rosenthal said the British public recognize attention-seeking when they see it. He has backed Britons to end the Megxit crisis by simply ignoring the couple and taking away the platform they require. He added, "I hope that the response of the British public will be as it should, to simply ignore Harry and Meghan and starve them of the oxygen they seem to desperately seek." The five-part documentary series The Me You Can't See, focused on mental health which Harry has co-produced, was released in its entirety last month on Apple TV. Don't miss Meghan Markle's desire to be in the spotlight sped up Nexit, comments Kate Middleton has to go through with a bizarre claim about William, insight Princess Beatrice and Eugenie wept after horrible fashion critique, report, it included large segments of Harry in conversation with Winfrey, as well as footage of a young Duke at Princess Diana's funeral. Harry accused the royal family of treating Meghan with total neglect when she felt suicidal and claimed they had felt bullied into silence. He said, "I felt completely helpless. I thought my family would help, but every single ask, request, warning, whatever it is, just got met with total silence or total neglect." Earlier this month, the Duke of Sussex also appeared to question the parenting of his father Prince Charles. Speaking during the Armchair Expert podcast, he said he would break the cycle of genetic pain and suffering for the sake of his own children. Harry said, "If his father Charles has treated me the way he was treated, so how can I change that for my own kids?" In March, the Sussexes made a series of bombshell allegations about the royal family during a controversial interview with Winfrey. The Duke and Duchess also accused an unnamed royal, not the Queen or her late husband Prince Philip, of voicing concerns about how dark their son Archie's skin tone would be before he was born. Meghan also told the chat show host she asked for help when she was feeling suicidal but claimed the royal family gave her no support.